Hello, my friends. How's it going? I'm your host, Stewart Farnaby, and I'm happy to welcome you to another fun and always exciting kid show!
How do you know if your clock is crazy?
How?
Because it goes cuckoo.
Hey, I've got a joke for you too. But first, here's a look at what's going to be on today's kid show. Nature Pete hunts for fossils.
All we have to do is look for them and pick them up with our fingers.
Special guest, Dizzy the Clown.
Stuart?
Hey, Dizzy, how are you?
Well, I'm doing pretty good.
Music from PB and AJ. Stan the Pan Man plays a new instrument.
So you can put this on a table. You can hold on to it with your hand.
And Maynard and Mrs. B share a new science experiment. And lots of fun on the kids' show. Okay, you ready for this joke? How do you know carrots are good for your eyes? Because you never see rabbits wearing glasses. Oh, look at him, he's a cute little guy. Next, we are going to meet up with Nature Pete. No time to waste, it's all yours, Pete.
Well, hey kids, we're out here at the Russell Wildlife Area, and this is one of the many fossil beds in this park where you can come and collect your own fossils. These fossils are from the late Mississippian period. That means they're about 325 million years old. Now that sounds like a really big number, but it means that they're older than dinosaurs. Most of the fossils we're gonna find here aren't very big. They're all about the size you can fit in your pocket. And if you're trying to figure out, well, which is a rock and which is a fossil, just remember they look like seashells. So all you have to do, don't need to bring any fancy tools, no pickaxes, shovels, leave your dynamite at home. Just come with your hands and maybe a bag or something to carry them home in. And all you have to do is get down on the ground and start looking. And I bet, you know, within, 2 seconds or so, you're gonna find them. Like right here, this is a brachiopod. That's part of a shell that was from an animal, something like a clam. And here's another piece of brachiopod. And here's a crinoid stem and a blastoid. There are literally millions and millions of fossils just right here at our feet. And all we have to do is look for them and pick them up with our fingers. Well, like right here is a brachiopod. I've already found two different species of brachiopods and a crinoid stem. This is part of an animal that some people call sea lilies, but they're actually not flowers or even plants at all. They're an animal something like a starfish. Biologists call them echinoderms. That means they have spiny skin. And so this is kind of like a sea anemone, if you've ever seen those on TV. Other ones we might see are bryozoas. That's a Latin word that means moss animal. We might find some trilobites. Those are little armored arthropods. They sort of look like an insect. This is one of those bryozoas. This is a piece of one. Now, all the fossils we find here now are gray. You know, their body structure has been replaced with limestone, calcium carbonate. But when these were alive, they were probably a rainbow of colors, greens and reds and purples and yellows. It'd be like swimming in a coral reef today, like if you went to the Caribbean or Hawaii, someplace like that, and went snorkeling or scuba diving. So that'd be a pretty neat place to go, see all these animals when they're alive. Here's another one that's just sitting here right at our feet. This is a horn coral. Some kids call these tornadoes because they look kind of like a twister. You ever eat those bugle chips? That's kind of what they look like. Well, I wouldn't bite into one of these because they would probably break your teeth. But these are an animal that sat on the bottom of the coral reef, and when they were alive, they would have had little tentacles that stuck out of here. And just like a sea anemone, they were filter feeders. And they would filter things that floated by, something that looked good to eat. Of course, they didn't have eyes, so they probably couldn't look at it. But something told them it was good. Now, most of the corals that we find today are colonial corals. That means they live together in a big bunch, just like the bryozoa. But these are solitary corals, or sometimes we call them horn corals. We can find little ones like these, or even big ones. Now, a lot of people have lived around Mahaska County their whole life, and maybe they've heard about the Russell Wildlife fossil beds, or maybe they were out here on a field trip in first grade. But they don't realize that these fossil beds are famous worldwide. You can go to museums all over the country and sometimes even in other countries and find fossils from Russell Wildlife in those museum cases because it's such a good place to look for them. And lucky for us, it's a public park. It's open access. You can come here and collect fossils anytime you like. A lot of places don't let you take them home, but out here you can because there's so many of them.
Thanks, Pete. Those fossils were great. It's game time. Guess what the picture is before time runs out. Figured it out yet? Oh, I'm sure you've seen this before. It's a butterfly! Now it's time for a special guest. Everyone clap your hands and welcome Dizzy the Clown!
Well, hi there, Stewart.
Hey, Dizzy, how are you?
Well, I'm doing pretty good. I'm just a little dizzy today, though.
Uh-oh.
But guess what? Yeah. I've got a cool magic trick to show you.
Oh, I like magic tricks.
You do? Oh, this is going to be so good. Now watch. I've got this piece of paper here.
Yep.
I'm going to walk right through it.
Walk right through it? How are you going to do that, Dizzy? I mean, the paper's so small and you're so big.
Now look here. I'm just going to cut a little hole right in the middle and then I'm going to walk through it.
Well, if you say so.
All right,
I guess it is magic.
Well, it is a cool magic trick. Now watch this. I'm going to first cut the hole just like this.
All right.
Do, 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 do. See? Now looky there. I got a hole.
Well, that's... You can't walk through that hole.
Wait a minute. I'm not done yet. I've got to cut a little more. I got to make the hole just a little bit bigger.
Well, okay.
Here we go. Do, hey, I just thought of a riddle to tell you while I'm cutting this up.
What's that?
All right, now let me tell you. There were these two brothers, and they were going on a canoe trip.
Oh, I like the canoe.
You like canoe trips? Well, listen, these two brothers, they went on a canoe trip, and their names were Pete and Repeat. And they went on this canoe trip down the river, and Pete fell out.
Uh-oh.
Well, you know who was left in the boat?
Repeat?
You want me to do it again? Okay, okay. Well, anyway, there were these two brothers, and they were going on a canoe trip, and they're going down the river, and guess what? Pete falls out. So you know who's left?
Repeat?
You want me to do it again?
No, wait.
Okay, now listen. I'll tell you one more time. These two brothers, they're going down the river in a canoe, and Pete falls out. So you know who's left?
I don't know if I want to say.
Guess what?
What?
You don't have to say. My trick is ready. I'm going to walk through that hole now. You ready? Here we go.
Well, that's a much bigger hole.
Whoa, what do you think of that?
I can't believe it. You actually walked through that piece of paper.
I did walk through that piece of paper. And I gotta go, so bye, kids. Woo!
Wow, that was a neat magic trick. See ya, Dizzy. If you want to see more of Dizzy, you can check her out at timewithdizzy.com. You guys ready for some music? I know I am. Here's PB and AJ to share a song with us. Oh boy, I can't wait to hear this song.
Stuart.
This is gonna be great.
There are 7 days in a week, don't you know? Some fly by and some go slow. It's not hard to remember these days. This little ditty helps us to say Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Saturday. Check your calendar, it's easy. It will show you the days of the week. Monday through Friday, we're learning and burning. But Saturday and Sunday, we put up our feet.
Only 7 days in each week.
Doesn't seem like much, doesn't seem like much.
But each time one week ends,
here comes Sunday, another week begins. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Saturday.
Why can't skeletons play church music?
Why?
Because they have no organ.
Kids, Stan the Pan Man here to show you another set of instruments. Both these instruments are the same thing, but they just look a little bit different. These things are called castanets. Everyone say castanets.
Castanets.
Castanets have these interesting looking type of contraptions. Actually, let me show you one of these. It's very, very super cool. This castanet has two pieces of wood, and each piece of wood are going to be clapping down on each other. Now, if you see on each of these pieces of wood, we have a little bit of the wood that's all kind of dug out on each sound, on each side. And with this, when both pieces of wood clap together, the pocket of air that gets trapped inside of here creates a really cool sound. So that's what a castanet is, and we have two different types of castanets. The first thing you'll see over here, this is a set of plastic castanets, and it has the same kind of thing, and it's hit on top of another little piece of wood to create a little cool sound. So you can put this on a table, you can hold on to it with your hand. If you have it on a table, you can create a really cool sound. You can also use your fingers to create a couple of little double hits. So now that's the sound of the plastic castanets. Now back to this castanet over here, I have two separate ones, and both of these castanets can be taken out of this thing. This is called a castanet machine, and each of these castanets are on an individual stick. And what we can do with this set of castanets, we have a little contraption here where we can close the castanet or we can open the castanet. And doing this will depend or allow us to create a different attack on the castanet. If I hold on to these, I can play them individually onto a stand, or I can play this onto my leg. Cool, huh? You can do it this way. Yay! Now, if we toss it into the castanet machine, it'll kind of react the same way as this other smaller unit. Hear how they have a couple of different pitches? Now these are made out of wood.
Cool. Hey, thanks, Stan. That was great. Next, we're going to see what Maynard and Mrs. V are doing. To the science lab!
Hello, you're back with Mrs. V.
And Maynard the Lion. Hey, everybody.
And we have another neat science experiment for you today.
What are we doing today, Mrs. V?
Well, today we're going to think about why it is when you catch a baseball that you pull your hand back rather than holding it out, rather than holding the glove out when you catch the ball.
Okay, why is that?
Well, there's something called impulse.
impulse.
Uh-huh. Impulse is equal to the force times the time that that force acts.
Okay.
And they're inversely related because if you increase the time, you decrease the force.
Okay.
And so when you're pulling your hand back, mm-hmm. then the length of time that the ball makes contact is greater, so that means less force.
Oh, and so that means it will hurt less.
It will hurt less, exactly. Mm-hmm. So I've got a little neat experiment that I want to show you that deals with that idea.
All right, well, what are we doing?
Okay, well, I brought some eggs.
Ooh.
And first I'm going to drop an egg onto the towels in this pan.
Okay.
And so the towels in this pan, they're soft. And so that means when the egg hits those, it won't hit the table right away because it will extend the length of time as the egg drops. So here we go. Let's drop an egg on the towel.
All right. Whoa, look at
that. Notice?
It didn't break.
The egg did not break. Now we're going to drop an egg on the tabletop.
Oh, I think I know what's going to happen.
You know, you might end up with egg all over your face. So how about if we put it in a plastic bag?
Oh, that's a great idea, yeah, Mrs.
D. We'll put it in a plastic bag so it doesn't fly all over you, Maynard.
Less mess.
Right. So let's drop it and see what happens.
Oh, look at that.
Okay, notice what happened.
It broke
because there was no extension of the time.
Nope.
It just hit right away.
Yep.
Whereas when we dropped it into the towels, it extended the length of time, and so the force was less.
And that is impulse.
Force times time is impulse. Very
good. Wow, that's really cool, Mrs.
Yeah. And I think it's really neat that we use all these things every day, and we don't think about them.
Yeah, that's really cool. Science is everywhere.
Science is everywhere. You are so right, Maynard.
No, I try sometimes.
Well, I think that's all for today.
All right.
And so, Stewart, back to you.
All right, bye, kids. See you next time. See you later.
Thanks, Maynard and Mrs. V. That was great. Well, this show has almost come to an end, so let's take a look back at Moments to Remember. Well, that's it for today's show. I'm Stewart Farnaby, and remember, my friends, you'll miss all the shots you don't take. Bye, everyone. Farewell. Adios. Ciao. Sayonara. Auf Wiedersehen. Shalom. See you next time.
You can pick up one of these identification keys in the Nature Center, and you take this along with you when you're hiking.
Repeat.
You want me to do it again? Okay. Well, anyway, there were these two brothers.
It's not hard to remember these days. This little ditty helps us to say.
We can do it this way. Hey! Now, if we toss it into the castanet machine.
You know, you might end up with egg all over your face. So how about if we put it in a plastic bag?
Oh, that's a great idea, Mrs.
We'll put it.
I'll see you next time on The Kids Show!
Sit and see what happens.
Oh, look at that!
Okay. No.